just wondering, you know, what you think of his passing.
Yeah, I've always thought Zach's a great passer, you know, playing with him in the second unit the last couple years. Just seeing his IQ, he's not afraid to make the pass. You know, we have a lot of guys that are great cutters, and Zach does a good job of getting them out early and before the defense even knows it's coming. So he's got a great feel for the game. I think his confidence has just continued to grow even more since he's been in the lineup, like you said.
Yeah, just overall as a starter, he seems to, you know, it's an opportunity he's been waiting for.
For sure, man. I'm so happy for him. You know, all the injuries he's been through the last few years, to finally get this opportunity where he's playing big minutes. He's shooting the crap out of it right now from three, pick and pop threat, and he's got grunt, you know, like our coaches say. He's not afraid of anybody. You know, he'll stick up for his teammates, and he's done a great job all year long, to be honest.
Is that playmaking or facilitating element, is Jakob had a lot of that. Has he been able to sort of slide in and do, I guess, the best that he can to replace that stuff?
For sure, yeah. You know, I think a lot of that stuff comes with, like, reps and playing time and just knowing that coaches trust you. And with Zach sliding in the starting lineup when Jakob left, it just gave him that much more opportunity, and coach lets him play through mistakes, and he trusts him. So I think he's just kind of taken that opportunity and ran with it.
How is he? I mean, obviously he's more of a shooter than Jakob was. How much has that element of his game changed the way that starting group plays a little bit?
Yeah, it helps us a lot because, I mean, he bails us out a lot with that pick and pop three late in the clock, early in the clock. I think he was like 4 for 5 last game or something. So he's putting. He's making the defense definitely think about it, and that right there is a threat, and that's why he's able to get a lot of passes because people aren't dropped off 10 feet from him. So I think that helps him a lot with the passing game too.
What have you seen from Sandro in the time that you've been practicing with the player?
I love Sandro. I mean, I haven't really known him at all, but he just got here. He's got a high IQ like most Europeans do. You can tell he's been playing for a long time, knows the game. Obviously was with the championship team, so he brings that to us. And just an unbelievable locker room guy. But what he did the other night against Jokic, you know, in Denver, coming in, not really playing for three quarters and coming in and having 11 quick points and having to guard the MVP was very impressive. So we're all loving having him here.
And I mean, you know, pretty much his whole short career so far, like you said, played in Milwaukee and was behind a lot of guys in the roster, kind of waiting for his time.
Yeah.
You think that helps in a situation like the Denver game, and what do you think that means for him to get more of an opportunity here?
Yeah, I think it's huge. Obviously, he learned under some great players like Brook Lopez, Bobby, all those guys in Milwaukee. So I think he's definitely got a high IQ, like I said, and he just needed an opportunity. You know, there's a lot of guys in the NBA that can play that are on the bench because they don't have an opportunity. And we're providing that for Sandro, and he's taking it and running with it. So it's been fun to watch.
The Blue Jays made the tournament, right?
Yeah.
What are you expecting out of those guys in the field of 64?
Oh, man, I have high hopes. You know, they got a great team. They're very talented, had some preseason hype, had some injuries, and they're here. They got NC State, and hopefully we get a little Baylor showdown in the second round so me and Jeremy can make a bet or something. I'm not dyeing my hair, though, I'll tell you that much.
I was just about to ask.
Yeah. Go ahead. Yeah. Yeah, they're a really good team. They're young. They play with a lot of energy. They're led by two really good wings with Paulo and Franz Wagner. They're going to get it and fly in transition, and then they're also going to be really scrappy defensively and try and force turnovers. So I think we need to clean up the turnovers from last game, and we'll have a good shot to beat these guys.
Doug, how's the thumb? Is the wrap just precautious?
Yeah, just precautious. I got to stop dunking so much, you know. I got a little bruise on my wrist, but that's not going to hold me out. But just management now, having it on, but feeling good overall shooting and cutting and just trying to be a good teammate, close out these 15 games the right way.
I know you're kind of joking about dunking too much, but it seems like you have been a little more aggressive getting to the rim. Is that a conscious effort or just taking a little?
Taking what it gives me, you know, they're playing me so aggressively on the perimeter. I think OKC was blitzing me off those handoffs. So you got to kind of choose the next option. If you can't get a shot off, you got to play off the bigs like Zach. So I get a lot of back cut dunks. And I'm just trying to run as much as I can and transition to get some early ones. And that's kind of opened up the game for me a little bit.